fat in cheese. Many consumers, including members of my own family, food writers, chefs, and self-proclaimed nutritional experts, continue to believe that cheese is associated with an unhealthy diet. I've seen people afraid to eat cheese, worried about the fat. Why? Because of the fat scare. The emphasis on cutting fat in the diet brought about by the change in the dietary guidelines in the 1980s has been refuted based on empirical research, meaning in the real world, noting that the recommendations against fat have led to an increase in obesity since they were first released by 35%. The fat we eat and its relation to diseases like obesity, cancer, and heart disease defies easy explanation. It's more related to the balance of fats than any one particular fat. So the guidelines put the emphasis in the wrong place. Cheese, despite containing saturated fat, is regaining its importance to the diet because, as Dr. Artemis Simopoulos says, who is the foremost leading expert on fatty acids in diet in the world, cheese is especially high in calcium, and calcium links with saturated fatty acids to keep much of them from being absorbed. Dr. Simopoulos, who I will mention again later in the segment on the Mediterranean diet, is the president of the Center for Genetics, Nutrition, and Health, based in Washington, D.C. She recommends eating an average of an ounce to an ounce and a third of cheese per day in her book, The Omega Diet. Because of the fat scare, many people, especially women, turned away from natural dairy foods or substituted highly processed, low-fat or non-fat cheeses in their diets, a decision that has led to a precipitous drop in calcium intake. Since cheese is also nature's most accessible source of calcium, it should be an important part of everyone's diet. You should balance your diet over a few days, not by each individual food, but by the overall diet. So if you eat no cheese for a few days, you can make up for it on the fourth. Or if you eat 5 ounces one day instead of the average recommendation of 1 1/3, take it a little easy on the cheese for a few days. You can't get away from the old traditional adage that goes back all the way to ancient times through traditional cultures, that the best diet is one where you eat a variety of foods with, according to the guidelines of the World Health Organization study on Mediterranean diet in Crete, the healthiest diet in the world, at least 50% of the bulk of what you eat coming from vegetables, and that you don't consume more calories overall than you expend. So have an active life, eat lots of good veggies and salads, and enjoy your meat and your cheese. Again, at least 1 1/3 ounces of cheese per day on average.